Hey everyone, it's ABJ here, and today I want to showcase our net drift tool, which is a tool we use to determine the direction of price based on the amount of calls and puts entering and exiting the market. Hope you guys enjoy.
All right, so this is our net drift tool. It shows a cumulative view of all the calls and puts flowing in and out of the market for your filtered asset. So here I have SPX. In essence, how we can read this is when the green line goes up, it represents calls being bought. When it comes down, it represents calls being sold. And that would go the same for the red line, just representing puts. Now, this is what the market looked like on February 12th, right here on the right. We can see that it generally grinded upwards. And this is our powerful net drift tool on the left. Now, I will actually want to showcase the importance of filtering. And so if you don't filter, you're going to get a lot of noise, false convergences, things like that. So this is what it looks like on February 12th with my filter. So I'll show you what it looks like if I just clear everything. So look at that. Doesn't look very clear, right? So what this means is if you're not filtering, you're actually looking at every order coming in for that day. So for example, if someone was buying deep in the money calls for SPX all the way down in December, unless looking at those strikes are part of your core strategy, personally, I'd want to filter that out. So with our ability to filter out the noise and only focus on the orders that matter to us, in this case on stream, this is the filter that I personally like to use and showcase for day trading. I only want to focus on the most aggressive short-term orders for day trading. So I'm going to go ahead and show you again how I filtered it so that I got that nice curvature going upwards, showcasing calls dominating. So first I go for zero DTE, so I change the expirations to the 12th. Session date, we're going to leave that alone. Moneyness, I only want to look at out of the money orders, right? This is the most aggressive order. And for the filter groups, I have this one. So this is ABJ, exclude tied and complex. In this filter group, you can see that I've excluded complex trades, tied trades, so spreads, any floor trades, any floor trades that are complicated, and canceled trades. So I'm going to go ahead and activate that, and you'll see, look at that. Nice, smooth, linear transactions coming in, showcasing calls clearly, aggressive calls dominating the market on that day. Right, so doing this, you'll see the smooth curvature. And now I'm going to go forward in time. I want to show you what the 13th looked like too. So this is the 13th. Right, same thing, market just grinded upwards. And change the session date to the 13. There you go, look at that. Just smooth, linear price action. And you can actually see that calls just started to dominate puts right here, like right around London Power Hour. Right, so we see very similar things on this 12th and 13th. So for the filter, this is the filter that I have. It's public. You can see it's public. You can actually find it in the filter public filter groups and use it for yourself. This is the one I use most often for day trading. And yeah, that's the power of our net drift tool. You know, we are using these tools to look for clues in market direction. And I can tell you that this was all we needed to see to let us know that long was the way. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I look forward to showcasing more of our powerful quant data tools with you guys. See ya.